Now live IV with McGee in close, stop VO on G, and smacking VO on A.
Hi, well here we are in the basement of TV3 preparing to do John Campbell's Campbell Live show. It comes on the back of some pretty strong poll showings for the National Party in both Colmar Brunton's TV1 poll, where we were 25 points ahead of Labour, and the Herald Digi poll, where we were about 17 or 18 points ahead. So Campbell invited us in. It's a full half an hour show. He tells me it's the first time he's done this since a whole full half an hour show like this since David Longy was in his dying few months. So quite an honour to get on the show and to have that much time. An opportunity to sort of traverse a whole lot of different issues, hopefully for viewers to get to know me a little bit better. And one of the things he's going to talk about on the show is the video blogs we do. So hope you enjoy it and look forward to your feedback as always.
Welcome back, everyone. John Key is our special guest tonight. Your questions, and there are many of them coming up. John Key, are you a well-meaning nerd? I mean, are you the world's straightest man?
No, I wouldn't describe myself as the straightest man.
Did you smoke dope at university?
No.
Why not?
My mother smoked and I hated it. And I spent my life as a young child campaigning here to give up smoking.
So this was an objection to carcinogens rather than...
Sure. And when I went to university, I mean, marijuana was the drug that was around. Everything else was pretty much off limits. So I was just never interested in smoking.
Were you ever a boy racer or a hoon or any of that kind of stuff?
No, not a boy racer. No, well, not, I don't think you'd describe my Mori 1000 as a boy racer.
Okay, so when you were making your view of the world, what was your expectation about what your life would be like? You start out from a state house, you have a solo mum because your dad has died, no money. Why did you think you were capable of becoming a multimillionaire?
Primarily, I think, because of my mother. I mean, she was an Austrian Jew refugee when the Nazis invaded in 1938. Her aunt married a British soldier to get her into London. So, I mean, she had a really strong view of what I should do, and I think that just rubbed off on me. So she expected hard work. There were no excuses. If you did things wrong, she laid down the law. She was a very loving mother, but she had very high expectations of me.
Okay. I